Hello everyone, this is Lucas on TechStacked, and today I'm doing a completely different video, not the normal tech news show that you're probably used to within the last three shows or so. Today I'm doing a little bit of a sort of tutorial highlight review type video. Being a content creator, I always like to look at lots of technical things too, considering TechStacked, the show itself, is self-produced. That's me. I do all the editing and all that. So I always like to dig in and look at all new features and stuff. And this past week, Adobe gave us quite a few updates, and one of which I wanted to look at, actually a couple, are of the Essential Graphics and Essential Sound we have here. And this just totally caught me off guard because I'm totally used to just using titles and stuff for text manipulation and all that. And so, yeah, let's take a look. So, Essential Graphics, what do we have here? So, essentially, we'll pull up this panel here. And I'm actually going to drag it up here. Maybe. Okay. And basically, what they're giving us here is a whole bunch of different types of titles, lower thirds, captions, all that sort of thing. You can see there's the stuff for credits. There is stuff for graphics overlays, for names and stuff, or actual lower thirds, and all sorts of things like that. Yeah, even social media things like, share, subscribe. But yeah, I just want to show you a basic title that I would use. Okay, so basically now how this is all working is manipulated right in the program monitor. So I can move all my text around. I don't have to do any of the title editing within its own editor. And it's basically just all here. And I basically use the text tool right down here. Type whatever I want. Just put my name in. There you go. And of course you can, from the Essential Graphics panel, you can change all the different size, styling options, fill, stroke, shadow, all that good stuff, as you normally would with any other text that you're used to manipulating within Premiere. But this is all great and everything. See, now if you go to the effects controls, you can, you know, manipulate it around the position scale on its own. And you can actually control all of that right here. All that stuff you saw right here in the Essential Graphics, it's all right here within the effects control. So you can basically control every aspect of that text all from the effects controls after it's made, which is great. One little thing I did notice here, like this particular new Lucas Cyprian Essential Graphics layer thing, it's not really like an item in your bin over in here anymore, and it's all pretty much just managed directly within the composition, which is a little different. In case you want to get rid of it and, you know, you want to bring it back at some point, you just don't want to do that, I guess. You just got to keep it on your composition somewhere. Which I thought was a little weird, but that's okay, I guess. I can get used to that. Now, here's one important thing I thought would be good to point out. Okay, so here's actually one of my nests, and I use one of the old-style titles. So basically what I do is I have a template. If I want to have a source in my show, I state the source with a text file, or a text title, I should say, and basically just edit that template to, you know, whatever the source is for that particular story. In this case, it was Facebook. So normally I could just bring up that title like you have. It's still all here. I can edit that title and all of its numerous options with the text, and I'd be good to go. So yeah, I can obviously still do that. However, if I want a new title, like one of these old style titles, you can't go up here anymore. The titles part of this menu is gone. It's now replaced with graphics, obviously to help with the Essential Graphics stuff. So how do I make one of those old titles? Well, you can actually just go to File, New, legacy title, and then you'd go through all the same processes of what you're used to and making a title, and you're good to go. So you can still do that. You could still make what are now called legacy titles. And that's just great, I guess. It's just something we're all going to have to get used to. Now, another thing alongside of Essential Graphics was Essential Sound. So I'm just going to select this particular voice clip here, and I'll bring up the Essential Sound panel, and I'll drag that up here as well. Now, basically what you can do is you can select a particular audio layer and throw on a whole bunch of different effects on it. And basically, they're presets. And it's not particularly one particular adjustment. It's a preset that controls a whole bunch of different attributes to whatever the audio you're trying to affect. And it's all pretty clear-cut.
And now they're great. Trying to structure yeah. it to now allow I sound more like I'm coming out of a radio.
Sounds pretty terrible. I would never use that for that case. But yeah, it's all nice and easy stuff. I wouldn't say advanced users may use it right off the bat. Maybe to make your own different types of presets. Absolutely. That's something I'm going to look into. But for beginner editors, something to just like look at for cleaning up different audio or making it sound cool or outside a building or whatever you want to do with it. This is nice and easy to apply to your audio and be done with it. They also threw those essential sound effects into Adobe Audition, which I'll show you right now. So basically, if you record a particular audio file, which I did right before this tutorial.
Recording an audition. This is a test recording. Check 1, 2.
Which I think I have an equalizer on that right now that I don't want.
Recording an audition. This is a...
Okay, yeah. So there it is. You can't actually do anything with the essential sound on a direct waveform. It only really comes into play once you're actually working on a multi-track session. So basically, you know, you go to your particular track you want to do effect, and you go and, you know, throw whatever effect you want on that, so on and so forth. And yeah, it's all pretty much the exact way it's set up in Adobe Premiere, as you had seen. Yeah, it's all pretty much the same, and of course looks a little different just because the box is on a different size panel and all that, but it's all the same. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I just thought it was really interesting how Adobe threw in especially the essential graphics and how that's going to affect our workflows now. But yeah, just something I wanted to point out and show everyone. Again, I know this is way different video than what's expected to show up on the channel, but if this is something you like and you want me to do more of these like creator, editor, content creation type videos, then hey, tell me, and I'll make more, because I like looking at all this stuff. So yeah, until next time, I'll see you all then.